We'll get ourselves started.
So you do.
I thought a wintry background was more than appropriate for tonight, and I think you'll appreciate the first hymn, first song. So we're a day later today, this week, because of our Scouts Carol service last night, which was lovely to see the kids and their leaders and folks in church. And I was just saying to people today in the office that I must be getting old, because there's nothing nicer than hearing kids singing Away in a Manger. And although they weren't all too sure of the "Oh, come all ye faithfuls of this world, leaving you little donkey." So they're still learning the same songs at school. So a day later, but nonetheless, we're glad to be together. So some things will appear on the screen as usual on yellow that if you wish to join in, you're more than welcome to do so. We come together in this place to be together and to claim that we are God's people. We look to ourselves and to each other to express the love of God as a sign of hope for this world. We abandon ourselves to the working of the Holy Spirit, trusting in God's mercy. Amen.
Amen.
So as we remember that we are in the middle of winter, that we think of the words of Christina Rossetti, a favourite carol that we sing together at Christmas time.
Frosty wind blade blow.
Let's come together in prayer. Father, we come before you in prayer, praising you, worshipping you, and thanking you for the life-changing, transforming love we have found in you. A love that reaches out into our lives, a love we find in friendships, community, and worship. Reassuring, comforting, and guiding us. Today we're giving thanks for all those who reach out in support and friendship, enriching the lives of disabled people, enabling and welcoming all into worship, into the presence of the Saviour himself, going through the roof to bring us to Jesus. And so, and please join in, may we reach out in fellowship. Amen. We're in the season of winter, and the season of winter can mean a lot of things. The season that we're currently in, or the season of winter in our lives. So that's the thought of the prayer that Stanley will lead us in now.
A winter prayer. There is a winter in all our lives, a chill and darkness that makes us yearn for the days that have gone, or put our hope in days yet to be. Father God, you created seasons for a purpose. Spring is full of expectation, buds breaking, frost abating, and an awakening of creation before the first days of summer. Now the sun gives warmth and comfort to our lives, reviving aching joints, bringing colour, new life, and crops to fruiting. Autumn gives nature space to lean back, relax, and enjoy the fruits of its labour, mellow colours in the sky and landscape as the earth prepares to rest. Then winter, cold and bare as nature takes stock, rests, unwinds, sleeps until the time is right. An endless cycle, and yet a perfect model. We need a winter in our lives, a time of rest, a time to stand still, a time to reacquaint ourselves with the faith in which we live. It is only then that we can draw strength from the one in whom we are rooted, take time to grow and rise through the darkness into the warm glow of your springtime, to blossom and flourish, bring colour and vitality into this world, your garden. Thank you, Father, for the seasons of our lives. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We're going to hear the words, "Wait for the Lord," as we do over the season of Advent, and you can join in if you wish. And this sung prayer response, I think, features one more time as we come to the latter part of our time together.
Psalm 146, verses 5 to 10, from myself. Happy are those whose help is the God of Jacob, whose hope is in the Lord their God, who made heaven and earth, the sea, and all that is in them, who keeps faith forever, who executes justice for the oppressed, who gives food to the hungry. The Lord sets the prisoners free. The Lord opens the eyes of the blind. The Lord lifts up those who are bowed down. The Lord loves the righteous. The Lord watches over the strangers. He upholds the orphan and the widow. But the way of the wicked he brings to ruin. The Lord will reign forever, your God, O Zion, for all generations. Praise the Lord.
Prayer of confession and supplication. Merciful God, we come confessing our sins and shortcomings. Though we try to put the past behind us, all too often we are haunted by mistakes. Though we try to make amends for the wrongs we have done, we find it hard to escape a sense of guilt. Often we ask you for forgiveness, but find it hard to forgive those who treat us badly. Remind us that you are always ready to offer free and total forgiveness. Forgive us for the times we have marred your image within us. We are sorry for when we have made assumptions about people different from ourselves and excluded those who Jesus went out of his way to include. Help us to accept your forgiveness and to forgive others. Receive then our thanks and lead us forward, granting us grace to worship you aright. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
So throughout this time of intercession, whenever I say, and so, we are invited to join in the response. May we reach out in fellowship. We continue in prayer. It is difficult at times, gracious God, to wait upon you with that expectant hope, recognizing that you are the God who acts in each season of the unfolding year and in each season of our lives. We recognize, even as we march through this Advent season, that we are marked by a sense of expectancy, for we are surprised by the ways in which you repeatedly come to us, particularly in our vulnerability, our struggle, and our suffering, and you remind us that you share our humanity in Jesus Christ. As we delighted in the gift of carol singing last night, and as we are reminded even by the carol that has greeted us at the beginning of this time of prayer, it is in the very bleakness of midwinter that you come alongside and offer us strength and an indication that you are the light of the world. Even as candles were lit yesterday in the church and on Sunday, we are reminded that you come into our midst, offering us fresh experiences of hope and grace mercy and peace, love and compassion and joy. It is thus our privilege to pray again and to pray as those joined together by your Spirit. In awareness of the movement of your Spirit, we pray truly that we might be mindful of those we represent. And so may we reach our fellowship is not only shared amongst ourselves, and we thank you for the gift of this time. We thank you that again we have been able to meet this week and for our shared participation in the bringing of our gifts, the words carefully crafted, the prayers that lead us into a deeper awareness of you. We thank you. But we are mindful too of those we represent, most immediately and obviously those we love and are near and dear to us, but especially the wider gift of the church and those we encounter. Last night, we were reminded that indeed we belong to a wider fellowship that extends beyond Bells Hill into places such as Airdrie and Coatbridge, to places such as Overton and Wishaw. We pray truly for an enlarged awareness of who we belong to. Give us eyes to see and ears to hear, eyes to see those that you are calling us to pay particular attention to in places of work and retirement, in places of influence and community, in places of conversation and congregation. We pray truly for the church and for the wider sense of community. And so, may we fellowship, loving God, starts locally, but extends further and further afield. It is thus always our privilege to pray for our country and for a wider sense of the United Kingdom and indeed our neighbors, a sense of us belonging to an incredibly diverse place, facing a variety of challenges, aware of some of the challenges that are presented even by our association with the continent. We may no longer necessarily be formally engaged with the European Union, but every day we are reminded that we do indeed belong to a wider sense of community and country, of language and exploration, of a sense of people belonging together and in their own tongues bringing an appreciation of who you are to each other and to us. And so we pray for our country, beloved as it is. We pray too for the sense of our shared belonging to Europe and further afield. We pray truly that we might learn from each other and together might thrive and encourage each other. Look for the movement of your Spirit, particularly at this Advent and Christmas time. And so, may we reach out. And dare we say it, even as the Acts of the Apostles witnessed to it so long ago, the story might start in Jerusalem, but it extends to Judea, Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. We're reminded that we belong to a global community. And thank you indeed that even through the gift of ministry such as the Organist Entertains, we are able, by the gift of modern technology, to reach well beyond the borders, not only of our country and Europe itself, but indeed even the southernmost tips of Africa and Australia, Australasia, and dare we say it, even across the Atlantic Ocean. We pray truly for an awareness of our global belonging. The earth is vulnerable. We are ever mindful, even as we enter a period of profound cold, that there are other places marked by famine, drought, flood, and uncertain climes. We pray truly that in an awareness that we belong to a global village, we might truly be conscious of those who are particularly vulnerable. It is our privilege and our responsibility to pray for those at this Christmas season who find themselves out on the streets, who are homeless, who are vulnerable, who, because of the pressing reality of the rise of the cost of living, find themselves at their wits' end, at the end of the rope. We pray truly for a world that reflects your justice your righteousness, your compassion, and your mercy. Remind us always that when we pray as one family, irrespective of our skin color, our cultural background, our language. And so may we reach out in fellowship. Fellowship is rooted in prayer. Our prayers are expressed for obvious reason in and through the gift of words, but we recognize that you know our hearts long before we find words to express them. And so, loving God, we thank you that when you were with us in Jesus, you taught us a prayer that encapsulates everything, that reminds us of a profound sense of our shared belonging, and that knits us together in fellowship. And so even as we prepare to pray that prayer together, we pray, and so may we reach out
in fellowship.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy
name.
Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, the glory forever. Amen.
Picking up some of the verses that we heard from Anne, we will, with a gladsome mind, praise the Lord. Let's all say together this Advent blessing. O come, Emmanuel. Go with us now into the world.
We can
begin again. Everything is about to change. So make everything new. Make us new. Reveal your glory in our lives and in the rhythm of our lives, so that nothing will get in the way of your coming.
Amen.